sitting on her front porch in the early morning breeze. Sitting on her front porch, just an old friend and me. Drink a little coffee, read all the local news, talk a little gossip every now and then. Smell that ham cooking in the kitchen, a brand new sunrise in the sky. Sitting on a front porch, minding all your business. What a way to make the day go by.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And good Friday morning to you, and welcome to the front porch. It is the 15th day of March, I do believe. We almost halfway through. My name's Kenny Dean.
Hey, good morning to you. I'm Terry Mitchell. It's great to start the weekend with you. We're halfway through the month, as you said, and goodness gracious, we're before long, we'll be halfway through the year. It goes by in a hurry.
You're copying everything. You're taking every bit of my information away from me. You're stealing all my info. Mike Dinsmore, happy Friday to you, sir.
Happy Friday to you guys. I hope y'all got good things planned for the weekend.
Yeah, nothing.
The best thing we've got planned.
We'll crack the chainsaw up.
Ooh, that sounds like work.
I can watch you. I'll be prepared to watch you. You got a little chair I can set in out there?
In the
Absolutely.
Shade.
Absolutely. You can sit in the cat condo and watch.
Hey, buddy, it's been a busy week. It's been a great week. I know you've talked about repentance. We've just enjoyed the heck out of listening to your stories and the way you've told stories. And as far as church related, is anything that you need to promote this week for the weekend or the weekend's coming up?
Well, I think all the churches that are having their Lenten series is this week, and I know that next week the Episcopal Church, will have its Holy Week services. Right. So those noon services, I'm not sure. I hadn't seen in the paper who Brother Rob's got coming there,
right.
But they do a great job, and others that plug in. I know at FUMC 280 there will be a Maundy Thursday, and I'm not sure about a Good Friday, but others around the community, just a lot to plug into. And I know that on Wednesdays, FUMC 280's got a speaker and lunch every Wednesday at noon. So going through next week, Holy Week,
right,
it'll be wide open for the Christian churches in the community.
I'm glad to hear that. And again, we're glad that you've taken your time to be with us every day. And if you don't mind, we're going to let you wrap up our week for the Friday Thought for the Day.
Sounds good. And I'm using today, we're still staying on repentance, and this is an extraordinary repentance I want to share today. Out of the ninth chapter of the book of Acts, the first 22 verses, so I'll read rather quickly. Meanwhile, Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues in Damascus, so that if he found any who belonged to the way, men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. Now, as he was going along approaching Damascus, suddenly a light from heaven flashed around him. He fell to the ground and heard a voice saying, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? He asked, Who are you, Lord? The reply came, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting, but get up and enter the city, and you will be told what you are to do. The men who were traveling with him stood speechless because they heard the voice, but saw no one. Saul got up from the ground, and though his eyes were open, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand and brought him to Damascus, where for 3 days he was without sight and neither ate nor drank. There was a disciple in Damascus named Ananias. The Lord said to him in a vision, Ananias, he answered, Here I am, Lord. The Lord said to him, Get up, go to the street called Straight, to the house of Judas. Look for the man of Taurus named Saul. And at this very moment, he's praying, and he's seen a vision of a man named Ananias as to come and lay hands on him so he might regain his sight. But Ananias answered, Lord, I've heard from many about this man, how much evil he has done to your saints in Jerusalem, and here he has authority from the chief priests to bind all who invoke your name. But the Lord said to him, go, for he is an instrument whom I have chosen to bring my name before Gentiles and kings and before the people of Israel. I myself will show him how much he must suffer for the sake of my name. So Ananias went and entered the house, laid his hands on Saul, and said, Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appointed you on your way here, has sent me so that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit. And immediately, something like scales fell from his eyes, and his sight was restored. Then he got up and was baptized, and after taking some food, he regained his strength. For several days, he was with the disciples in Damascus, and immediately he began to proclaim Jesus in the synagogue, saying, he is the Son of God. You know, this is an amazing change in direction and behavior, which conversion is about anyway. Paul is on his way with arrest warrants to execute the Christians. His mission in life, as he understands it, is to eliminate this new movement called the Way. And then he has an extraordinary experience. Light flashes from heaven, the voice of Jesus. The question, why are you persecuting me? Get up, go into the city, you'll be told what to do. And there he meets Ananias, who doesn't really want to meet him. And he's healed of his blindness and becomes an apostle. The story, as we need and understand it today, is Paul, a Jewish Pharisee, has an experience with the living Word of God that literally transforms his life and the history of the faith journey. He moves from threatening murderer to a prophet of grace. He moves from a harsh man of judgment to an advocate for mercy and forgiveness. He moves from an independent authoritarian to a unifying encourager. He moves from persecutor to an advocate. And it doesn't matter what commentaries you use, Paul is credited with writing at least 13, if not 14, of the books of the New Testament, all because he turned from his wicked ways of judgment, condemnation, and divisiveness, and answered God's call to love all people in all times and all places. O gracious and holy God, in our time and place, this Lenten season, may we be transformed and learn to love all people, all times, and all places. Amen.
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 What a turnaround one man had that changed not just his lives, but many lives for his remaining years.
Oh, we talked about transformation. I mean, this is... You take the ugliest of the ugly and make it the... You know, now, Paul was not without conflict the rest of his life, but he never changed from witnessing to what he thought the truth was. And today, the Christian church would not be what it is without the influence of Paul. And, of course, there are people who argue the goodness and the complications of that.
Right.
But the scriptures are what we have.
Well, that's great. Again, what a great story to end the week. What a great story to go into the Easter. Where, you know, of course, we're already in the Easter season. But thank you for bringing so much light to the show and to so many folks this week, Mike.
We're supposed to be changing.
Well, you're in the process of surely helping us, my friend.
Hi, brother. Appreciate both of you.
Thank you.
Happy Easter to you and Miss Patsy and to Zippy and the cats.
Happy Easter to all.
Thank you, my friend. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Mike Densmore getting our day started at 61 degrees, 15 degrees warmer this morning than it was yesterday. It's going up to 76. Rain coming in here, I don't know, kind of mid to late morning, in and out all day long, 100% chance of rain, high of 76. Thunderstorms could be happening tonight. It starts kind of backing off, 57 for a low, about an 80% chance of rain, but it goes on into the night. Tomorrow, slight chance of rain, 73 and 50. Sunday, slight chance of rain, 69 and 42. Monday and Tuesday will be really nice, low 60s during the day, low to upper 30s at nighttime, then 70 on Wednesday and 43. There's your five-day forecast brought to you by Alex City Marine. They're located on Cherokee Road in Alexander City. Lake Martin, Daville Area Chamber of Commerce. Don't forget about March the 28th at the Funky Goat. Come on by and meet and greet, and just a time to see folks from 5 to 6:30. And maybe it's going to be a great opportunity to you to join Lake Martin, Daville Area Chamber of Commerce, a great place to call home.
King Honda Car World kicks off 2024 with an unbeatable selection of new Hondas, available now for immediate delivery. Experience great products and incredible selection and fantastic prices on all of our new Honda inventory in stock. Our goal this month is to make it a month to remember by offering year-end deals at the start of the year. That way you get the best savings on any Honda in stock. Need to trade in your car? We're offering top dollar for quality trades, making your deal even better. Plus, this month only, enjoy free leather upgrades on all Honda Accord EX models. And we've got plenty in stock. Thank you for making 2023 our best year ever, and we're excited for an even better 2024.
Thank you all for a great 2023. I welcome the opportunity to meet you in person at our Honda store, where I know our staff will take great care of you. We hope to see you soon.
Visit our new facility at 2332 US Highway 280 and start enjoying your new 2024 Honda this year.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff, or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Passion, the obsession that burns within. Determination, the burning desire to make it. Drive, the motivation to be the absolute best. Skills, the tools to perform at the highest level. Excellence, the feeling of achievement. At Central Alabama Community College, you can release your passion, show your determination, display your drive, and showcase your skills to achieve excellence. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
As your State Farm team, we will be there for you with the financial strength to deliver on our promises. Service that's a sure thing. You can think of us as your good neighbors who help protect what's important to you. We're here when you need us the most. You can call us 24/7 to get answers to your questions, file a claim, or see if we can find you more ways to save. We have many coverages and many discounts. We can help protect more areas of your life and find every discount you qualify for along the way. Please call us or visit 2048 Cherokee Road for coverage you can count on.
Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union, is looking for the next hometown hero. Hometown heroes can be first responders, public service workers, community leaders, pastors, community volunteers, or anyone who is making a difference in your hometown. Submit your nominations now online at myhscu.com. And if your nominee is selected, they will get a $100 Visa cash card and a certificate of appreciation from Heritage South Credit Union, your community credit union, federally insured by the NCUA.
The Rockford Pharmacy is now open Monday through Friday from 9 until 5. They're located across from Triple R Cafe in downtown Rockford. Go by and meet Leanne Armstrong and the friendly staff, or give them a call at 256-377-9002.
Hi, this is Brian Bice with Bice Motors. With our all-star lineup of Dodge trucks, Jeep, SUVs, and Chrysler cars, we offer the area a team dedicated to making your next vehicle purchase a positive experience. Our sales team offers competitive pricing, and we back up all sales with the service department second to none. Bice Motors also offers the area's best selection of pre-owned vehicles. Visit Bice Motors at 2133 Cherokee Road in Alexander City.
Welcome back to the front porch. Kenny is in a trance right now. I have entertained Kenny about the life of my cat and my cat's new condo.
He is getting weirder and weirder and weirder as weirder we end up being after three weirds.
Weirder. So, hey, talking about weird, I collect as many things. You know, I collect fountain pens and other pens. I've got a huge collection of fountain pens. But I started collecting vintage watches. You know how watches are today.
Did somebody bring that up?
Yeah, somebody brought that up. But I have. I found a lot of vintage watches I've gotten into. I'm talking about the kind of watches that your dad had that you had to wind. They were not automatic. They didn't have a battery. They had a mainspring in them. So, have I told you about my cat?
Weirder, and whatever he's fixing to say next is going to put him the weirdest. I can just go ahead and tell you that. Hey, George McDaniel, good seeing you the other day. And I told her, I said, next time you fix some peas and cornbread,
see, it's all
me.
About you.
Yeah.
Why don't you talk about what a great lady she is and a great cook she is and a wonderful, wonderful person. No, I want you to fix me dinner. What are you talking about weird? I tell you
what. Hey, we got a lot of egg hunts coming up. One is Passion Church on 63 North. That's coming up the 31st. Which will be Easter Day, that right after the service at 10, Easter egg hunt at the Arbor campus on Green Street, March 24th from 3 to 5. Oh, Easter Bunny's going to be here. Let me tell you what, that Easter Bunny may be out here on the show here before long. I'm just saying.
You've got a connection with the Easter Bunny?
Yep. Mm-hmm. Talked to him yesterday.
You holding out on me.
And then the snacks and inflatables will be that day also.
Hey, I got a big Easter hunt, two of them, and they're both on the same day. On March the 23rd, if you run over to the town of Rockford, be there about 10 o'clock. It'll be down at the old football field on the Nixburg Road. Go by there and you can hunt Easter eggs. Or at 9 a.m., go to Alexander City, to the Alex City Parks and Recreation Department, and they will have a big Easter egg hunt on the 23rd at 9 a.m.
Reverend Emerson Ware will have one at Perfect Peace Missionary Baptist Church, Spring Blast, Saturday, March 30th from 10 to 1. Easter egg hunt by the Alex City Parks and Recs and the Lake Martin Trailblazers, March 23rd. 9 o'clock, lower softball fields at Sportplex. Egg hunt begin at 10 o'clock.
Hey, and on March the 25th, which would be a Monday night, join the Coosa County Republican Party for their monthly meeting. It'll be held at the Coosa County E911 building. Refreshments at 6. The meeting begins at 6:30. And I can almost absolutely 100% guarantee you that Matthew Reams will be there, along with Jamie Johnson will be there.
Two
so
good guys.
Come out and talk to both of them. They're running for circuit clerk in Coosa County, and they'll be on the ballot on April 16th, the runoff ballot.
Did you know Julius Caesar died today?
I did, as a matter of fact. And today is also the Ides of March. And it was also on this day that Lyndon Johnson rolled out the Equal Voting Rights Act. So
Ides of March.
Ides of March. IDES.
I know.
And I know you studied that in school.
It's all about the eyes this weekend. The pies and eyes. weird. Yeah. Dan Adams' Life in Depth album comes out today. He and Suzanne were out here yesterday.
Get it at the Rumors Record Rack?
No.
You remember that?
Oh, yeah, I did. Easter extravaganza coming
big,
up.
Big, it's
the,
big.
The church, I'm going to still call it Trinity. I can't apologize. That's what I know what I asked for 100 years. But it's the church right next to the hospital. That's coming up the 24th.
Is it a
4 to 6.
Egg hunt?
Yeah, eggs extravaganza.
Eggs extravaganza.
Also, on up at Horseshoe Bend National Military Park, next weekend, next Friday and Saturday, hoping I can carry my little buddy up there because it's a free, it's a commemoration of the 209th anniversary of the Battle of Horseshoe Bend. I remember this battle. I was right in the midst of free annual event recreates the traditional Muscogees Creek life Frontier Life in the year 1814, right after Columbus discovered America, and emphasized the importance of the Battle of the United States.
What was the year again?
1814.
Took a little trip.
Mm-hmm.
Along what year
Colonel
did
Jackson
what
year did 1814.
What year did Columbus discover America?
1492. So you ought to know that, Terry.
Yeah, I do.
You ought to know that.
But my point is, you said it was just right after. It wasn't right after.
There ain't no point to anything.
It was a long ride. Look, I got to ask you. You said you wanted to take your little buddy up there.
Mm-hmm.
But
W.W.
That's right. But are you taking him up there because it's a great event for him to see or because it's free?
I didn't see, the free part hadn't even crossed my mind.
But you mentioned that.
Mm-hmm. Well, I want folks to know it is. It is free.
Good. That was my point. It's free to everyone.
See, your point's not well taken. Hey, our guest today, a cowboy professor, Michael Freeman's in the house right now. Can't wait for him.
He's out there talking to the fish right now.
Melinda Sealman will be calling in today to talk about the kiddos and cops, which will be tomorrow down at Pennington Park. Let her tell you all about that. We got a trail ride coming up next weekend that Robin Brooks and Tabitha Cleveland will be able to talk about. So that's a few things going on today on the show. Monday show, Kevin Moon is supposed to be here. Now, I've called Kevin and left word for him. I've not heard back from him. But Kevin Moon is supposed to be here.
Sounds to me like you're trying to get in touch with him right now.
Well, I left word for him yesterday because he's supposed to be on the show Monday.
I've got some real good contacts that can call him. Would you like me to reach out to my contacts?
No.
I'm here to help you. I'm from the government. I want to help you.
Hey, 4-H Gardening 101, March 19th from 9 to 11:30 at the Tallapoosa County Extension Office. It is a $10 cost. Get signed up for that. I think, you know, when Dr. Demo Papaya was out here yesterday talking about gardening, talking about the farmer's markets, that type thing. Grow it yourself. I mean, you know where it's come from. Then you know how the Indians used to fertilize.
Yes, I do. As a matter of fact,
they'd go fishing eat some of the fish and the dead ones. They'd put in it next to that corn, and it'd just grow. It'd be real kind of fishy.
Kenny. You're right about the fish. They did use them.
Mm-hmm.
But you said they would go fishing and they'd eat some of them,
mm-hmm.
and they'd put the dead ones. Now they didn't eat a lot. You made it sound like they ate live fish.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't eat live fish.
Professor, go back me up on this. He'd come out here and he'd tell you what kind of fish and what they caught those fish on back in 1814
The Indians did not eat sushi. They cooked their fish.
I ain't eating no sushi either. I don't care what you say. If you fry it, I'll eat it. Shepherd called it fried. Let's see.
Died, fried, and laid on the side. Laid on the side, that's right.
Matthew Rings is cooking half chicken plates now. This is March 30th. It's a fundraiser for the band, the Coosa County Band, to go to Florida for band competition.
That's right. Go by there, and that's a good deal. I think they're like $12, was that right?
You had the price
yesterday.
All right, I'm going to give it to you if I get it. $12, you're right.
I remembered it. See, I was paying attention yesterday. You don't pay attention.
I'm gonna tell you why.
Tell me why.
When we got something going on out here, it's him. He's over there looking at this, and he gets this. Man, I ain't never seen anything like it in my life. Anyway, am I lying or am I dying?
Yeah.
We'll be right back. Let me tell you about where the fun never ends. We're talking about Lake Martin, but you know what? We're talking about a creek. We're talking about any creek that you want to go sit on with your children, with your grandchildren, just by yourself. Just by yourself. Take it in. And Lake Martin, Tallapoosa County Tourism, we thank y'all for taking it all in for us.
George Feed and Seed covers both sides of the road in downtown Dable. Incredible selection of plants, stones, insecticides, and gift selection in the additional part. Original store has tack and boots for men, women, and children, gloves, hats, belts, and Carhartt clothing. Come on in and visit. Open Monday through Saturday for your convenience with a whole lot of service. Floyd's Feed and Seed, downtown, Dayville, Alabama.
We are Debt Relief Agency. We help people file Chapter 7 and Chapter 13 under the bankruptcy code.
This is Marcia Mason, your local Lake Martin Bankruptcy and Social Security Disability Attorney. Mason Law Firm is located at 217 Madison Street in Alexander City. Call 256-329-1313 to schedule your appointment today. All initial consultations are free and strictly confidential.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Trust Dixie Overhead Door to restore your garage door with a comprehensive tune-up. For a limited time, it's free for Dixie Cares Plan members and only $49.99 for others. Avoid a real-life nightmare and take care of the most important door in your home. Regular maintenance can reduce noises and potential breakdowns, extend the life of your opener, door, tracks, and springs, and quickly spruce up the space. Especially important if it's turned into your new man cave.
Central Alabama. This is our home. It's where we work, where we play, where we raise our families and grow old. And in the unfortunate event we become sick with cancer, thanks to UAB Medicine Russell Medical Cancer Center, this is where we heal also. We have invested in new technologies and expertise so that now we're able to treat all sorts of cancers and you never have to leave Tallapoosa County. UAB Medicine Russell Medical Cancer Center. Compassionate, convenient, collaborative cancer care right here at home.
Farmers and Merchants Bank of Dadeville is building a foundation of strength and trust in the entire Lake Martin community. With our modern branch in Dadeville and caring, attentive staff, we've established Farmers and Merchants Bank as a reliable friend to your banking needs. Whether it's just a savings or checking account or any commercial, auto, or real estate loan, Farmers has local decision-making to build a relationship with you and your needs. Farmers and Merchants Community Bank. Strength. Service. Community.
You don't have to ask who, what, or why. Whose Diner is the go-to place for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Conveniently located at the corner of Highway 22 and 280 in Alex City, Whose Diner offers the best meals and the best deals in town. Try our fresh made-from-scratch pancakes, chicken salad, Philly cheesesteak, or the Who Burger. It doesn't get any better than Who? Whose Diner, of course, on the corner of Highway 22 and 280. Who's hungry?
Henderson Towing, Alexander City, 24-hour towing, jump starts, door unlocks, local and long-distance towing, heavy-duty towing. So let's get old Big Hoss to the rescue today. Here's that number. Now keep it handy. Henderson Towing, 256-392-4554, 256-392-4554. Henderson Towing, 24-hour towing, 256-392-4554. Folks, we're fixing to get serious on this show. We're fixing because we've got a man out here that what I was talking about a while ago with the Indian and the fertilizer, the fish, and in fact they call it fish fertilizer. That's where fertilizer first started coming in for Triple 13 or any of that. But we got a man out here that will back me on what I just said, the professor Michael Freeman.
He'll back you all right. He'll back you right in the corner.
How the heck you doing, Dave?
All right, fellas. How y'all doing?
Let's tell them the reason for the cowboy hat. Yeah. I've never seen you in a cowboy
hat. Like a gospel group out here.
So it's the Bassmaster Classic month. The Bassmaster Classic's coming up, and the late, great Ray Scott, he was famous for wearing his cowboy hat at the weigh-ins. He always he started bass and started really what we know as tournament fishing many years ago.
Well, he had a vision for what happened.
You know, Bill Dance and Roland Martin and Jimmy Houston and Hank Parker. You could go on and on about all those folks that, heck, Rick Klun, who's still fishing today, you know, it ties back to when Ray started, you know, tournament bass fishing on a big stage.
So do you have a favorite fisherman? Any of those guys or somebody that you didn't, that it's why you're where you are today and the knowledge and how much you love fishing and learning about fish.
Well, considering my age, Bill Dance is always going to be up at the top because you saw him every week.
Yeah.
I mean,
Tennessee cap on.
Yeah, when that music would roll, when he'd start that show, it made you think about, man, I want to be on the lake.
Wow,
it
really?
It could be snowing outside. Man, I wish I was on the lake with Bill Dance, you know.
I'll be darned.
But probably my favorite fisherman who was on TV as well was Roland Martin. Roland's, you know, from down at Lake Okeechobee down in Florida. Mm-hmm. I just like this style of fishing.
Yeah.
And then I follow his son, Scott, who's a really good fisherman.
Doing the same thing?
On his own. Yeah, okay. He's a tournament fisherman, you know, BASS.
Mm-hmm.
Really good. And so it just the style, you know. I like the way they fish. And Hank Parker, as far as fisherman in person, you can't beat that guy. And he's also fellow South Carolinian. Mm-hmm. But Hank Parker is he's a diamond. Just his personality and where he's rooted at. Not to say the other ones aren't either.
Yes,
it's just I'm real familiar with him and just really impressed by what Hank Parker brought. The years that he fished, and you know, he does television. He even had an outdoor show where he did hunting and other things too. And his family's involved. He's got a daughter that does some stuff, but and his son raced. You know, he was a NASCAR driver for a while.
Wow. Do you have any things you do today that you learn from them that you pull from that you do a better job than them?
Oh, I don't know if I'd do a better job. If I did, I'd probably hear my name more on a, you know, television show or whatever, you know. But I love to spinnerbait fish, and it's
lost.
It's not something that's done. It comes and goes. There's so many other techniques out there that people like to do, but I love spinnerbait fishing. And I learned a lot of that from Roland and from Hank Parker in particular. Bill was... he loved crankbaits and jigs, and so, you know, you picked up a lot of stuff that he did with those.
Golly.
Spinnerbait fishing is my favorite thing to do as far as a type of technique.
What are you fishing for when you spinnerbait fish?
Largemouth in particular. And spotted bass, too.
Okay.
But largemouth, I like to fish around structure up in those trees, muddy water, clear water, doesn't matter. You know, you just change the, you know, the type of spinnerbait that you're throwing. But I really enjoyed catching fish on spinnerbait.
I talked to old boy the other day this week, and he was getting ready to go fishing. I said, "What are you fishing for? A crappie?" He said, "Catfish." He said, "I love to fish on the bottom."
It depends on the species of catfish too. You know, we used to fish Santee Cooper a lot in South Carolina, which is known for big, you know, 100-plus pound blue cats. And my uncle was really into it.
What do you fish
for? Fish those with a cow.
Cut bait.
Cut bait.
Yeah.
What kind
of
cut bait?
Sometimes we'd catch on herring. There's blue herring in those lakes. So you catch the herring. I said blue herring, and some people were thinking of the bird, but I'm talking about the fish.
Yeah.
But you take herring, and some you need to cut the bottom of it so it release the oils. They have a lot of oil in them, and that's what attracts the fish to it.
We
use herring, and sometimes, you know, just homemade baits too. You know, some of the guys would make up.
Did you ever catch one of those 100-pound?
No, I think 42 is the biggest.
That's
thing.
A
my
big,
uncle's caught them in
big
the '60s. Never caught a century mark, but they're in there and people's caught them.
Have you ever been? We grab them by the mouth.
My grandfather did that.
What not grappling?
Talking about noodling?
Yeah, noodling.
Yeah, my papa did.
He's
missing half of one of his fingers because of a turtle. But
you
know, I never
put it in the wrong hole.
Yeah.
Wow.
So I'm not much into that, but you know, there's a lot of people that are, and there's a young lady named Hannah Barron who lives in South Alabama, who's big. If you ever want to look her up, she's big into noodling. That's she's famous for. She deer hunts and has
now,
outdoor.
Is noodling where you reach under into a hole and pull them out?
A hole under a rock. They put boxes in waterways now.
Okay.
Set up to where it attracts these big fish to go up in them, and then they go down underwater and they grab them by the mouth and pull them out. And some of them are about as big as they are. And, you know, you got somebody with you to spot you because they'll drag you down.
Before we last saw him.
Yeah, exactly.
Wow. Yeah, I've seen guys that did that. And I've never heard of
anybody doing it on Martin, but they
Okay, so
I'm sure somebody's went up Tallapoosa River or something. It wouldn't surprise me because people do that kind of stuff. But.
Now, I don't remember the process, and that's when I ask you about noodling. When I was a kid, we used to be a few folks over on the Coosa River that cut this long cane, and they'd hang it across their boat. They only had like probably a 10 or 12-foot boat. But then the cane would drag in the water and kind of agitate the water. What was that called?
It was stirring up the bottom to draw in. Maybe they were catfish.
Yeah, they were catfishing, but it had a term for it, and I thought it was noodling then.
And what did they use? They
just used an old cane they cut off the side of the river.
Yeah,
and
disturbing the bottom so it would draw the fish to come up there and
see
of course, they get closer to your bait at that point.
That's right.
Probably what they were doing.
Have you been telephoning? Yes, no question.
No.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah, so that's some, they're underwater right now. They're gonna come up with a big old catfish.
This is Hannah?
That's Hannah right there.
She's not a very big girl.
No, she's not. Hey, she may not be tall, but she is a spark plug. She works out hard and she's something else.
She's from South Alabama.
South Alabama. She lives down
there.
I'm gonna look her up. Maybe
I'll
go by and visit.
She's
with
famous
her.
In the outdoor world.
Yeah.
when you say Hannah Barron's coming to one of your boat shows or something, I mean she's a pretty lady too.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
But because she's a rugged, no nonsense girl.
You don't want to mess with her,
no,
do you?
No.
He looked serious when he told you.
You see what she does to that catfish, what you think she'll do.
And that catfish looked like it was about as big as she was.
Oh, yeah. She's not tall, but like I said, she's thick. I mean, muscle. Mm-hmm, she works out hard, and that's how she makes it work.
Darned.
Is she able to generate income from doing this?
Oh, yeah. She's doing well.
But it's from the commercials and the endorsements.
Yeah, impressions, all the social media stuff. And it's funny, she's not TikTok because of the obvious reasons. She had some roots. Her roots are grounded, what I would say.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good for her.
Chinese knowledge. Mm-hmm. But she uses other social media platforms.
I'm going to look her up.
I'm going to check into her, too. I'd love to have her if she's ever come to this
place. You want to see if I can get her out on the show?
Love to do
sometimes
that.
I'm going to use you as a catfish and let her show me how she catches you.
I know she comes to the Birmingham Whitetail Expo and some of those things, so she does come through the area from time to time.
You probably need to up your budget to get her out here.
Yeah, we pay him big bucks to come out here. Wild game cook-off, is that something you go attend very often, or is it your schedule not allowed?
Sometimes.
You?
I used to go to them quite a bit in South Carolina,
right.
And I have been to a few here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm involved with the Alabama Wildlife Federation.
Yeah.
So.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoy those.
That's a good group of folks down there, too.
Yeah.
Fishing season, I know it's year-round, but
it's ramping up.
Yeah. Boy, I'm telling you what, the last on Lake Martin, these last couple weekends, there have been some more boats out there.
Yeah, big tournaments. Yeah. You know, Alabama Bass Trail was here last Saturday. It was 225 boats. I was out there in the middle of them. Caught a lot of fish.
225 boats in Alexander City?
That was just in that one tournament, Saturday.
And the weekend before, 222
the
high school.
That's right, a high school tournament.
Talking about.
Man, you're talking about a shot in the arm to the economy.
You're right.
Wow.
And so, there's been some big tournaments. Springtime in March is usually February, March, April. That's the
February,
target
March, and April.
Of all the big tournaments on Lake Martin. And, of course, it coincided with some of the heaviest rain we've had in short bursts. And so,
sure did.
You know, they put the plug in, and Mother Nature said, well, here.
Yeah.
Let me give you 3 foot of rain when it comes to what came in the lake. So when I came across the bridge there today, it's getting close to full. But there is a little bit of danger to that, too, if you're out fishing, especially at night. I would not advise running around the lake at night right now.
Because of debris?
Unless you're down mid-lake because of all the logs floating.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, there's
a lot
of debris
coming
in the water.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we have a tournament Saturday. Wind Creek Bass Trail starts back up Saturday. And, you know, I'll have to make sure that there's plenty enough light out there before I let them go because of the bottleneck.
Okay. Hey, don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Salvation Army is located at 6800 US 280. We won't tell you that first. Right now, this time of the year, with a lot of folks doing spring cleaning, they're in the closets, they're in their drawers, they're even outside in the closets in the shops. Clean it out. Well, let me tell you something. You need a place to take it. Get a receipt. Use it for your taxes. Salvation Army is the place to take it. You can do that today.
Hi, I'm Jimmy Gorey at Gorey's Furniture. Come join us for the madness of March. Come join us here at Gorey's Furniture. Make a purchase. Shoot from the line. 5, 10 to 15. That's percent discount off your total ticket. So come join us. Let's have some fun. Everyone's a winner. Everyone will save. Come join us for the madness of March. And that's only at Gorey's Furniture.
At Russell Medical, we're proud of our exceptional nurses, like Nurse Brandy Worthy. Brandy represents the selfless, compassionate clinical leader patients expect and coworkers admire. Brandy was recently honored with the Nightingale Award for Nursing Excellence for her high standards, sound judgment, and caring manner. Her passion for her profession inspires us all.
Being a nurse is not just what you do, it's who you are. I'm proud to be a part of the nursing team at Russell Medical. We are the link between all hospital services, providing you with exceptional, personalized care.
In today's challenging world, our children need every advantage found in their education and spiritual formation. If you're looking for a school for your child or your grandchild where they will receive a great education, be in a small class, a safe place, a school where they're prayed for and with, a school where the Bible is integrated into the lessons, a school where they're encouraged and challenged not only in scholastics but also the Christian life, Veritas Lake Martin Christian School may be the place for you. Registration for the next school year has already begun with limited spaces. Call us at 256-537-5004.
Let's get serious. Let's get Arctic Air serious. You want your car and truck to live longer, don't you? Well, it's about maintenance. Same thing with Arctic Air. You see the number at the bottom of the screen? Call them right now. Let me tell you something. You want to be comfortable? We all want to be comfortable.
Serving East Central Alabama since 2005, we are Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical of Sylacauga. Coosa Valley Respiratory has medical equipment and supplies, including oxygen-to-home ventilation services. We carry a full line of bracing, power chairs, scooters, and more. And when you trust Coosa Valley Respiratory, you are dealing with local people that care about your well-being. Providing quality home care for our community, Coosa Valley Respiratory and Home Medical, 201 West Fort Williams, Sylacauga. Give us a call at 256-245-1411.
The Alex City Parks and Rec Department serves the residents of Alexander City with quality facilities and programs designed to positively affect the lives of the citizens. From youth sports programs to adult activities and our senior center, the Alex City Parks and Rec offers services for all ages. The Cooper Rec Center, Lake Winds Golf Course, and the Senior Activity Center are just some of the great features the Alex City Parks and Rec Department provides for the people of Alex City. For more information on any of our programs, call 256-329-6736.
6:46 on a Friday morning with the professor out here, Michael Freeman. What is coming up that you really need to hit on right now?
Well, you know, OGS is we gave the month of February to MLF and all the and Bass and all mm-hmm. them to come through. So we didn't actually host a tournament on Martin in February for the first time in years, just to accommodate them because you know it's a lot for them to have to do. So mm-hmm. we doubled up in March. Our next Wind Creek Bass Trail event is actually this Saturday. Mm-hmm. At Wind Creek State Park, you can come out and register fish that morning, or you can do it online at Fishing Chaos and just type in the search bar up there, OGS. Also, we have a solo trail event over on Lay Lake the following Sunday, mm-hmm. and then on March 30th is our last of our six events of the Wind Creek Bass Trail. We're actually going to do the weigh-in for that event at the Ridge Marina in our partnership with Russell Marine. Mm-hmm. There'll be some bass cat boats out there for people to look at and different things that Russell obviously promotes. So we'll be doing that. It'll be the first time we've done a Wind Creek Bass Trail event where the weigh-in wasn't at Wind Creek State Park.
Oh, really?
It's kind of a one-off thing mm-hmm. that we're doing with Russell. And then the championship is the following Saturday for that. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we have the First Readers of Tallapoosa County the Saturday after that. And so we're fishing. We're going to have tournaments going on for the next 5 weeks, pretty much every weekend.
FEREST, First Readers.
First Readers. Yeah, have you had those folks?
Yeah,
on?
We have.
Lane Tooney and some of those, Sue Pagan. Mm-hmm. So, but there is another tournament that we are not putting on, but I wanted to promote it. So, the Horseshoe Bend High School Fishing Team has a bass tournament coming up on March 23rd at Wind Creek State Park, which is a week from Saturday. Mm-hmm. And so, you can sign up for that at the morning of the tournament right there at the ramp, and they'll start registrations at 4:30. It's $100 a boat with a $10 big fish, and then they got some optional stuff you can do on the side.
Man, you guys are busy. Hey, on Lay Lake, where do you guys put in?
Beeswax. Okay. Beeswax Park.
Where are you seeing high school fishing teams growing?
Some of them are really big and growing. Of course, the Alex City's team is really big. Mm-hmm. Auburn Anglers, I'm just some of the ones right mm-hmm. off. Elmore County has a good team.
But Clay County has
Clay one. Clay County, mm-hmm. that's right.
I believe Daville is Real Town.
Yeah, Real Town. Also Horseshoe Bend, of course.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And Daville High School has a team, or Daville. And then most of the high schools in our particular area have a bass team. There's a few, like Opelika High School, for some reason, doesn't have one. A lot of their kids will fish for Beulah or over at Auburn, you know. But other than that, most of them have a team, and they've been growing. All of it's growing. The college deal is really growing,
yes.
And it's busting at the seams, you know. You're seeing a lot more opportunities. We've talked about it here for kids to be able to, you know, fish in college and get scholarships and all that.
I think I brought this up for Wade Cannon with iPhone.
That's right. He's one of our sponsors. Yeah. This is our Wind Creek Bass Trail event.
He is big into giving back. You know, iPhone, I forget what you do
insulation.
With them. They'll give back to the school.
That's right.
And that's just, you know.
And that's what we do with Crank for Bank.
Yeah.
You know, they get money for each ticket mm-hmm. they sell. They get back.
That's
to
growing,
team.
Isn't it?
It is. And, of course, that starts up April 1st.
That's right. April Fools.
Yeah, April 1st on Lake Martin and on Smith Lake.
Mm-hmm.
Those are two separate events, but they're the
big
same
money thing. In this
goes
one.
To July 4th.
That's right. It goes to July 4th at 7 p.m.
Oh, okay. Just be exact.
7 p.m. to be exact.
But the cool thing about this, you don't have to have a $200,000 rig to fish.
No,
you
can have a John boat with a little hand tiller motor.
Or you can fish from the bank.
Because we're doing crappie and bass, 200 bass, 75 crappie.
Mm-hmm.
Both lakes the same way. So
you could catch them on a cane pole.
That's right. All you got to have is a line, a rod,
and
a hook.
And be pre-registered.
And pre-register 2 hours before you catch that fish. Mm-hmm. That's a key, because we want, you know, it has to be done that way for on purpose for a reason. We've had some people that sometimes try to get a
– You
get
can't
a
be expo facto.
You can't catch the fish and then register.
Well, you know, one thing about – and with you coming out here, with Vivian Autry and others coming out here – this is well run, because when you start talking about the money that's involved in it, they can't have any Any issues on any area?
It's no different than a golf tournament.
Okay.
Or you put on a benefit other events. So we use a company that they provide us with the game plan that we have to follow to make sure that those things are taken care of. So, and we do that. And you have polygraph tests for every winner and all that kind of stuff. So
it's just crazy how it's growing. I'm not a fisherman. I know our buddy, our producer, Ryan Fuller, is. He's already signed up to catch that $1 million fish, and I'm pulling for him.
I want to make sure if he catches $1 million fish, he'll show back up here on Monday morning.
Yeah, we won't ever see him again.
He'll show up on Monday morning and say, "Guys, I won't be here."
But really, this is, you're talking about those high school teams, fishing teams. You're talking about the college. What I'm seeing out of it is the work ethic that starts then. If they start it then, Michael, that we got a pretty good chance we're going to see it on down the line.
Yeah, in one form or the other. So example is that Logan – I use Logan Parks and Lucas Lindsay, a couple of guys that I watched come up through Auburn Anglers when I was boat captain and another team with that group. Logan has went on, and now he's a Bass Elite angler, doing great things on that end. Lucas was his partner through college, up in at Auburn. They've both done some great things. Lucas and his partner, his now teammate, Brendan Holt, they just finished second in ABT up here last Saturday. And Lucas is starting to show the things that he did. And they were teammates, and they were very successful in high school and college. And, you know, Logan's going his way of being successful. Lucas is going a different route, and he's being successful. So
it's fantastic.
Yeah, you know, there's multiple ways of getting to where you want to get to.
Yeah.
It's just whether or not you want to put in the time. Because you have to put in the time. A lot of talk with forward-facing sonar and all this new technology. If you don't know how to use it and how to apply it, the fish aren't going to jump on your hook.
Mm-hmm.
You still got to catch them. You still, and you have to make sure that you're fishing for the right fish. You know, just because you see a fish on there doesn't mean it's the one that you need.
Mm-hmm.
And there is techniques to that. That takes practice. It's no different driving a race car. It takes time in the seat. You know, it was one of my other dreams that I never fulfilled. But as far as I love racing, and so you got to be able to hit those marks. It reminds me in some ways with the way fishing is today. I know it's obviously a different sport. It's bowling. I used to be a state champion bowler when I was in high school.
Never knew that.
If you don't hit that mark every time and put the same spin on the ball and the same follow through, you're not going to get a strike. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it's a lot of practice and a lot of time.
Oh, it's just what a sport that's grown over the. I've seen just out here since been doing the show last few years, but it's been going on longer.
Yeah, but it's really exploded the last 10
okay,
years.
Okay.
I mean, I'm just really over. It's not overnight, but I think what really got it going, in my opinion, is especially in this state, was when people like Matt Lee and Jordan Lee were at Auburn at the time, because Auburn's team's been really good for a long time. They put a lot of effort into it. Matt went on to the Elite Series. Jordan's won 2 Bassmaster Classics, you know, the Super Bowl of bass fishing. These guys, it was at the right time when social media was really taking off and everything just kind of hit side by side and it just exploded.
Timing.
And in my opinion, it started here in Alabama.
Wow. You know what? We've covered a lot of ground. The fish report we really didn't get to today, but just get out there and fish.
They're biting.
Yeah. That's a good way to end it. Thank you so much for being out here with us. I'll give you a call. Look forward to you being out here in April.
Absolutely.
I'll be right back. Coon's Corner Deli. Let me tell you what's going on.
We talked about fish. That's what they're having at Coon's Corner Deli today. They've got some fried fish.
Yeah, they already called them fried fish fillets. Some folks call them fillets. Chopped pork barbecue, loaded potatoes, broccoli, cheese, and rice. green beans, fried okra, corn, mac and cheese, and peach cobbler. Let me tell you something else that's going on, but I have to wait to next week to tell you on that. Coon's Corner Deli, Hillary Street.
For over 80 years, the staff members of Radney and Langley Funeral Home have been friends in time of need, and we are dedicated to honoring, sharing, and preserving the amazing and inspirational stories of life.
You've got a friend.
Obituary is brought to you by friends at Radney Funeral Home and Langley Funeral Home, and thank goodness we have no obituaries to report today. But to the men and women that are fighting for our freedom, God bless you. And to the families that have lost loved ones recently, my heart goes out to you. We'll be right.
Whether it's Lake Martin, Lay Lake, or Logan Martin, boaters from all over the state of Alabama come to Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama, because it's worth the drive. With the best deals on unbeatable Suzuki outboards, Manitou and Landau tritunes, and a great pre-owned inventory while they last, Alex City Marine is the pros the locals know. And no matter where you're from, when you're here, you're local to us. Alex City Marine, just off Highway 280 in Alexander City, Alabama. AlexCityMarine.com.
Arise is public transportation from downtown Alexander City. Now, from downtown Alexander City, they cover a 20-mile radius. Those vans are all over the place. When's the last time you went to see that friend? When's the last time you really needed to go to the doctor, but you didn't have a ride? Well, now you got one. It's Arise. Remember this. It's public transportation. Their number to call is 256-329-8444.
Have you been to Sure Shot Outdoors lately? Owner Scott Watson invites you to come in and take a peek at everything they have to offer. Not only do they carry the products you need, whether you're a beginner or an experienced shooter, their experienced staff offers both knowledge and the service you deserve. They also carry apparel, grills, coolers, and much more. Come on in and browse Sure Shot Outdoors today, your one-stop shop for all things outdoors. Located on Highway 280 in Alex City.
Grace's Flowers in Alexander City on Hillaby Street has been making people happy for decades. Susie Kelly and her friendly staff continue that same great tradition. Grace's Flowers is a full-service florist for all occasions, funerals, weddings, and other special events. In addition to flowers, Grace's has a great gift selection as well. To send a smile or encouragement, call 234-4238, and Grace's Flowers will deliver. Grace's Flowers on Hillaby Street in Alexander City.
Jeremy Worthy with Worthy Plumbing and Construction is carrying on a great family tradition, proudly serving the Lake Martin area and doing new construction, plumbing repairs, remodels, and a whole lot more. So keep this number handy, 205-936-4705. That's Worthy Plumbing and Construction. Again, the number to call is 205-936-4705. That's Mr. Jeremy Worthy.
Announcing Lake Martin Medical Center's new address at 815 Lee Street. Dr. Bazar Rafai offers services in primary care, provides bioidentical hormone pelleting, and specializes in treating leg sores in the Lake Martin and surrounding areas. Our med spa also offers IPLs, laser hair removal, and a variety of aesthetic products and procedures for your skincare needs. We're your one-stop shop to looking and feeling your best. Call 256-212-9300 to schedule your appointment. That's 256-212-9300.
With the new year ringing in, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is ready for your lawn and tractor needs with a great selection of new and used Mahindra tractors and implements or Spartan mowers. And we're not just selling, we're buying. We'll buy your used tractor, car, truck, boat, motorcycle, even if you're not buying from us. And we pay on the spot. Whatever your tractor or mower needs, Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor is doing business and paying on the spot. Lake Martin Tractor and Outdoor, Highway 280 across from Home Depot.
Thank you.
7:01 on a Friday. Of course, the show has been pre-recorded, as we do every Friday. And I thank Ryan for doing this. I thank John Kennedy for allowing us to do it. So it gives us a little time. I always wake up on Friday morning before the show, and most times earlier than that, because not that Ryan doesn't do it right, but sometimes something will kick out and he has no control over. But most times,
sometimes Ryan doesn't do it right.
Huh? Sometimes Ryan doesn't do it right. Aunt Ruby, I don't know why, I'll stay up and I'll wake up, because I know Aunt Ruby's going to let him know if he got the wrong
show.
Well,
I still get up at 3 o'clock on Friday mornings, but, you know, I'm not worried about the show.
Hey, we do have here shortly Adam Russell. We've got the trail ride, the late Adam Russell doing scholarship.
I'm looking forward to seeing Robin and Tabitha.
And they do a great job. That's going to be next weekend. So we'll be talking about that here before the show is over with. Oh, I was going to tell you, on April 1st, I forgot. I don't know why I forgot this food right here. But George Miranda is the other April food that will be not out here at the same time. I don't know if I could take that. But with Chuck Bradley coming up.
What day is April 1st on?
Monday.
Oh, I hate I won't be able to get out here with you.
I really hate you're not going to be here too.
You'd have another April Fool out here, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I know. I'm just fixing save
it. I'm going to make it a little smoother for me.
Rain, it's coming down right now, kind of in and out today. So be careful if you're out and about.
Raindrops falling on my head. Like a man's feet's too big for his bed. But let me tell you about something else you need to do. Mule Day's coming up. Kenny loves Mule Day over at Will Guffka. He's been there several times. In fact, Kenny likes it so well, he has his own parking spot for Mule Day. And you can get your own parking spot, too, if you'll call Mel who?
Palmer.
At 256-249-8885 and tell him you want to be a vendor for the April 27th Mule Day at Will Guffka. What'd you learn from Will Guffka last time you went over there for Mule Day?
I'm just trying to remember when I went. I go when y'all, most of the time I try to make it when y'all have the coach events there. Not sure if I went last year. I can't remember year to year. Don't remember day to day.
It's a big event, and they usually make a little syrup, too.
Do you ever go into a room and you forget what you went in there for?
No, absolutely not.
I do. I know y'all do too.
Yeah, you know I do. Sometimes.
But if you stay there long enough and look around, it'll come to you. And sometimes I have to walk out and then I have to go back in just to make sure.
I thought you were going to tell them that you walk into the bathroom and you forget why you're in there.
No, most of the time I know.
You can remember that.
I know that. Let me tell you what. We got hot running water again.
Congratulations.
Yeah, it's just the little things in life. But let me tell you what.
Did Ellen light the?
No, Farron
did.
Now, Ellen.
Did Farron teach her how to do it in the future?
She knew how to do it. It was just dry until she had almost got blowed up the other night.
Yeah, that was kind of exciting. You was telling me.
And good morning to you, Melinda Sillman.
Good morning, Kenny. How are you?
Man, and I'll say happy Easter to you right off the bat, too.
Thank you. Same to you.
We got the Kiddos and Cops coming up one more time, the fourth annual Kiddos and Cops on Saturday, tomorrow from 12 to 5. Looks like the weather's going to be good for y'all. It's been kind of iffy, Melinda.
Yeah. We've been checking the weather, and the rain percentage keeps going away, which we are ecstatic about.
Let's talk about what's all about, what's going on with this, because this is a great thing, and I'm so glad that y'all get and do it again, because our guys and gals in blue, they need to be recognized in a kind way, I guess I can put it that way.
Hey, I agree. So, Kenny, you know, like, I created this event about 4 years ago due to an incident that happened with my son and the police. Unfortunately, you know, it was a case of, you know, mistaken identity, which is fine. Of course,
yes, ma'am.
You know, I wasn't happy about it. I was upset. So, therefore, you know, I had to figure out a positive outcome for this incident. So, you know, I thought about it and I thought about it. So I created this event. I did this to, you know, help bridge a gap with our community. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a lot of misinformation out there that, you know, we don't know. you know, they have a job they have to do. The example, if whatever they were doing that particular day, I would expect them to find who they were looking for. So, you know, my biggest thing is, you know, I want us all to be a community. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
It takes the community and the police. That's the only way we're
going to
survive.
I agree. You know, Linda, I was talking to a lady the other day, and we were just talking about different things, but she told me about her son, Jimmy Abbott, and someone from the Tallapoosa County pulled him over for driving and drinking. They had him in jail. And this was a mom saying, leave him in there. And, you know, and it was one of the best things that ever happened to that young man, and you know, sometimes as a mom or as a parent, that's hard to do. But sometimes they got to be taught a lesson. Do you agree with that?
I agree with that 100%. The kids are our future.
You're right.
You know, that's why we have to we got to teach and train them. And you know, when we teach and train them, when they go out there, we should be able to trust them. But they got to understand, you know, everybody has their part in this community to, you know, to make it go. The guys in the blue, they have a job.
Right.
If somebody came to rob you, who are you going to call?
Oh yeah,
that's right.
You understand what I'm saying? They have a job. You know, we got to know the law. When you're riding on the highway, you got to have a license.
Right.
It's not about picking at you and all that other kind of stuff. You know, they have a positive impact, and that's what a lot of people don't understand.
Well, that's why I'm glad that y'all are doing this tomorrow at Pennington Park. It's from 12 to 5. We're talking about kiddos and cops. You get a chance to meet and greet, but also, on top of that, you got fun and games, and you got some food, and you got some music. That's pretty good day to me.
Kenny, hey, we got new donors this year. Man, we're going to have hot dog, hamburgers, pizza, chicken tenders, you name it, we got it. We're going to have all kind of activities, bouncy houses, the video gaming, face painting. We're going to have different other little vendors that come in. We're going to have first readers. They come in, you know, they're going to be there. The kids' parents sign up. I think they're sending them a book every month, mm-hmm. you know, to help them. You know, we got vendors from your area that's helping out. Cassador's Mexican Restaurant,
oh, yeah.
Ellis City, Walls, Tires. Man, we have so many people that help us make sure that, you know, this event goes off every year without a hitch. You know, we're going to have, of course, your Hula Hoop Frisbee. Mr. Gaddis Pizza is one of our biggest donors this year, and I know everybody loves pizza. We're going to have the 360 booth. You're going to have your fire department. You're going to have a train, churches. I mean, man, when I tell you it's going to be awesome, I mean, it's for everybody, kids and adults. I think the Dixie Youth Football is going to be there. You know, if the kids want to sign up for that, they can. We got it all for them. And I just want this to get bigger and bigger every year. Shout out to Mr. Kirk for always maintaining that park and letting us use it. It's phenomenal, man.
Yeah, Kurt and Lee Fitchner, of course, they with Pennington Park, they have grown that for all kinds, from Christmas to kiddos and cops events there. And it's downtown Dadeville, Alabama. Tomorrow, again, the weather is looking pretty good tomorrow afternoon. So y'all come on out and enjoy it for the 16th, I'm sorry, for the 4th annual. It'll be 12 more years, and I hope we're still talking about it.
We will.
Melinda, thank you so much for calling in. Thank you for letting us be a part of promoting this for you. And you know where we are for next year, okay?
Hey, Kenny, I appreciate you.
Thank you, Melinda. Have a great weekend.
You too.
Yes, ma'am. We'll be right back, folks. Tell them about it.
It's happening right now in Kellyton, Alabama. We're talking about what's going on at Forbes Auto Sales. They've got a lot full of good, clean, used cars, trucks, regular cars, SUVs, Jeeps, whatever you're looking for, they got it. The sky's always blue at Forbes Auto Sales. Go by and see them today for those good, clean, used cars, or just go by and see them for some good auto advice or parts sales and service. Forbes Auto Sales, Highway 280, Kellyton, Alabama.
OGS Tournaments presents Crank for Bank. Win over $1.6 million in cash and prizes. Over 200 tag bass and 75 tag crappie are waiting to be caught by you in Lake Martin. Register now online at crankforbank.com for only $120. All ages are welcome. Fish from the dock, boat, or the shores of Lake Martin to win over $1.6 million in cash and prizes. It's Crank for Bank.
For years, Tom Watley's been a name you can trust to represent you. And now you can depend on Tom Watley Law, LLC to handle all of your legal needs. Tom has over 20 years of practicing criminal defense, probate needs, and estate planning. Tom Watley Law supports the communities of Lee and Tallapoosa County and can handle all your legal needs or refer you to their network of specialty attorneys. When it counts, call Tom Watley Law, LLC at 334-559-3420 or online at tomwatleylaw.org. No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be provided is greater than that of other attorneys.
Hillaby Towers is an affordable senior citizens community located in Alexander City on Highway 22 East. Spacious one bedrooms are available now. Great location, peaceful setting, comfortable living where pets are allowed and utilities are included. Call today to find out more information on Alexander City's best kept secret, 256-329-0552. That's Hillaby Towers in Alexander City.
Medicare for Veterans, MedicareSalute.com. Medicare for Veterans, helping to maximize your VA, CHAMP VA, and TRICARE benefits. Call 256-675-5315 today. Ask for Amber Walker. Ask about Medicare, life, health, dental, and final expenses. Do that today. Call 256-675-5315.
Inspired by the bold bison, Southern Union students blaze new trails every single day. They press forward knowing their SU education will lead them to success. Affordable, accessible, and locally unparalleled. Whether you're transitioning to a university or launching straight into a lucrative career, a degree from SUSEC can help you blaze your path. Three locations, dedicated faculty and staff, endless possibilities. It's all waiting for you at Southern Union. It's time to venture forward. Register today.
If you haven't been to Big B Barbecue in Alex City, then you're missing the best barbecue around. Big B has everything from the best pulled or chopped pork, chicken, and beef to cheeseburgers and grilled chicken salads. Bring your friends and family out for a great dinner and sit outside on our beautiful patio. Or sit inside and enjoy your meal by the fireplace. So come in and join us and enjoy the best barbecue in the area only at Big B Barbecue, located on Highway 22 West in Alex City.
$500 over invoice now at Tony Serra Ford. Every new Ford on the lot, $500 over invoice when you trade in finance with Tony Serra Ford. Plus 3.9% financing for 72 months. Save thousands on new F-150s and more. All backed by Serra's lifetime warranty. No charge. Every new Ford, $500 over invoice at Tony Serra Ford. In Sylacauga, TonySerraFord.com.
Right now, rain kind of in and out. Yeah, it's going to be kind of a nasty day. 76 for a high with some thunderstorms tonight. Still a few thunderstorms hanging around. 80% chance of rain, low of 57. Now, going into tomorrow, you just We got the kiddos and cops over at Pennington Park. We have a pretty good day for it. 73 and 50, 69 and 42 on Sunday. Slight chance of rain. No rain Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. In fact, Tuesday, I'm liking both these days weather-wise. 64 low, 30s at nighttime. Then on Wednesday, 70 and 43. There's your five-day forecast brought to you by
Top Gun. Oh, who
come
else?
On, come on, come on, get in. Get
no,
into
I can't. I'm not.
Top Gun, best control.
I can't compete with you. I bet you next week on Monday and Tuesday you'll have a fire.
I had one. It dropped down to 62 the other night. I had one. I had to wait a while. I had to go outside and kind of and get a chill, and I walked right back in.
I hope you get some firewood this weekend.
Yeah,
because I'm concerned. I'm deeply worried about you.
Hey, you know, I appreciate when I throw something out on the show, and hopefully it's something good, and it gets back to who I was talking about. Keith Meigs, the other day I was talking about, I think I'm going to need another half quart of load, another half quart of wood. And he, about 2 hours later, he called me and said, Kenny, said, I heard you needing some wood. I said, you heard right. I think I'm going to throw out, sure could use $1 million. I did with some kindling a few years ago, and I got all kind of kindling
sure
steel.
Did. I remember that.
I think I'm going to try $1 million.
Let me know how it works out for you. How do you measure a half quart of wood? Do you know how?
He measures.
You haven't gone into that equation?
No, I trust him. Trust Keith Meigs. I've been buying my wood from him for years.
I didn't mean you didn't trust him. I just wondered if you knew how to do it.
No.
Okay.
Don't want to know how to do it.
All right.
I know when a half cord is a lot of wood, and I'm down to this
it's
is
half as much as a cord.
This is going to be three cords I've burned this year. That's more than I've ever burned, but I have fires more, of course. I think it's been cooler. Maybe
I think you're getting older.
That has something to do with it.
But the one thing I can tell you about, you don't get it. You must get warm at home and maintain that heat throughout the morning show out here. Because
it's cool. Because
it's cool.
I'm going to admit, it's cool.
If it was cool, I'd feel good. It's cold. It's real cold, Andy.
Well, it's going to be a pretty good day today. What's your plans for the weekend? And I don't tell you, what are you doing? Dead blame cat.
Oh, my cat and I are going to be doing what? You don't see the picture of my cat?
No, I don't see no picture of a cat.
On her condo.
I don't see it.
Diane's sister's coming in this weekend. I think Diane has got some outdoor planting projects. Diane and her sister both love to plant flowers and work in the yards.
Mm-hmm, good.
So I'm going to grant them that opportunity this weekend.
I would. I'd move out of the way.
I am. I'll be there just do the lifting and the grunting. And,
ooh, not me.
Oh, yeah, I like to do that. I like to hear them talk. They just go on with each other and have a really good time. And
where's
then,
your sister from?
Atlanta.
Oh, that's right. That's what I thought.
Yeah. So they'll have a good time. We'll do that. Later today, I'm going down to Montgomery to help out on a board I sit on in Montgomery, so I got a little work to do down there, and then I'll be back later this afternoon to probably cook some whatever they want me to cook on the grill, too.
Cause, oh, yeah.
You know, I'll be doing that. But it's going to be wet. It's going to be real
it's
wet.
It's kind of a nasty day, so be careful. Yeah, about and his sister going to spend the night with us tonight, both of them. We will have a bed full when we wake up in the morning. Mm. And she wakes up with that little pretty smile, and he wakes up and talking, Papa, and boy, he's just wide open. But
does he wake up in a good mood?
Oh, yeah, he does. And she wakes up just big old eyes of hers, and that hair. Her hair is just like Maggie's when she was a baby, just as curly. She's got curls on top of curls. I haven't cut it yet, and it's long.
I bet it's pretty, too.
But we're looking forward to that tonight.
So does WW wake up ready to eat, or does he?
Ready to get up. Yeah, he doesn't like we don't lay around much in bed.
Can you get him to watch cartoons on Saturday morning?
Well, but it's old cartoons.
It's a different cartoon.
Yeah.
It's not the KD Terry.
I really ain't got him into Bugs Bunny and some of those yet. But they don't do this very often, or he doesn't do it. He's doing it more. And you know what? I'm glad because it's gonna come a time in a few years to come, and I hope it's longer and short, but he's not going to. He's going to have his own friends. So I'm going to, like I've done since he was born, I'm going to hold him till he doesn't want me to hold him anymore.
That's right.
Same thing with her. But time, let me tell you something. You hear me talk about it all the time. Take time with your children. Take time with your grandchildren. Something you never can get back, and they'll remember it.
That's right.
I've said this 100 times.
I talk to mine almost every night.
Yeah.
Well, I don't talk anymore like we used to. We FaceTime each other.
Yeah.
We look at each other. You know, Kenny,
That's okay.
Yeah, but I feel like George Jetson. You know, when you and I were growing up, on Saturday morning, we watched the Jetsons.
Mm-hmm.
And they would do these things that we're doing today. Except,
what was his wife's name?
Jane.
Mm-hmm. What was his boy's name?
Elroy.
And the girl?
That'd take me a second. Jane, Elroy. Rosie was a maid.
Oh, wow. Okay.
But
so much of that.
What was the daughter's name?
Well, cute little thing. If you think a cartoon girl's cute.
Yeah.
Kind of weird. I don't know, but.
He worked for Spaceless Sprocket.
Yeah.
George Jetson.
You must have just seen it recently.
No, I've got this incredible memory to remember useless stuff.
Boy, you do. I'd have to admit.
Diane tells me all the time, she says, you know, you're just full of useless information. That's
Diane, I agree with you. I'm going to call it something more than that, but I can't say it right here on the show.
She doesn't say that either. Let's see. Jane, Elroy, Rosie.
Jane, his wife. And that little girl comes.
That's right. She come bopping out there.
But yeah, here again, I don't like to knock today's TV, music, cartoons, or anything, because it's not what I grew up on. You know, and it's you know, they probably don't like to watch what I grew up with, but a lot of it they do. Hey, if you're into this SEC tournament, basketball tournament,
I'm gonna watch it.
It started Wednesday, then it goes all. I guess it goes through the weekend, right? Or
yeah, it goes through.
I don't know.
Yeah,
just one weekend.
I don't think it goes through Monday. It may end on Sunday.
Okay, dear. Thank you for letting me know. We'll be right back. Cloud Nine, I'm going there today to see Amanda Subman, see what the selection of the ladies' wear is looking like. Ladies, moms, and dads, we've got a dress just for both of you. The ones we're showing, I would love to see that on mom and dad, or not mom and dad, mom and daughter. And I hope you'd send us a picture. That way we know you're trading with the new owner of Cloud Nine in downtown Alexander City.
At Beyond Home Care, we provide in-home care services to individuals needing assistance with activities in their daily lives. We work with each client to provide personalized home care and sitter services, whether it's assistance with bathing and personal care or an escort to a doctor's appointment. Each client receives the individual care they need with the dignity and respect they deserve. Give us a call today at 256-414-6090 or visit us online at beyondhomecareal.com.
The Morris Haynes Law Firm focuses on representing those who have been injured or mistreated by the wrongful acts of others. We have offices in Ellic City and Birmingham, but we have been calling Ellic City home for over 30 years. If you find yourself in need of a lawyer, give us a call at Morris Haynes, 256-329-2000. We would be honored to help you.
Lake Martin Mini Mall is geared up for spring with new inventory arriving daily. See our huge selection of big green eggs and accessories, along with our expanded lines of high-density daybreak outdoor furniture and complete solar lighting kits for home, patio, decks, and docks. Lake Martin Mini Mall is also excited to announce our local farmers and artisan market starting March 23rd, offering farm-fresh vegetables and foods. Shop Tuesday through Saturday and mark March 23rd on your calendar for our spring kickoff party.
Music Depot, located next to Depot Gun and Pond on Highway 280 in Alexander City, is stocked and ready for you to visit. Huge inventory of quality name drums, amps by Glaney and Fender, electric and acoustic guitars, pianos, fiddles, every accessory you need for yourself or band. Before you shop out of town, shop Music Depot on Highway 280 in Alexander City. Call 256-234-6767.
At CNT Electric, our clients are our priority. For the safety and security of your family and home, our technicians are professionally trained, drug tested, background checked, and wear uniforms with name tags. We're proud to have served the Elk City, Dadeville, and Lake Martin areas for the past 10 years. Give us a call at 256-234-0007 for all your electrical service and repair needs. Or visit us on the web at www.cntelectricllc.com and spell out the word AND.
Jesse Henderson, owner of Henderson Glass on Dable Road in Alexander City, says give them a call today for a price, 256-234-5464. They do auto, commercial, residential, showers, shower enclosures, mirrors, tabletops. It's all about glass, so I'm seeing clearly if you are. Again, that number to call is Henderson Glass, Dable Road, 256-234-5464.
Hello, this is Scotty Gordon at Cornerstone Insurance. Are you tired of paying too much for your home and auto insurance? If so, give us the opportunity to help you. At Cornerstone, we have three goals for all of our clients: asset protection, affordable pricing, and superior customer service. Come by and give us a call today to see what we can save you. 153 Alabama Street, 256-409-2299.
You know, it's what this makes me want to do.
Top Gun, Best Control. That's what it makes me
want. I would have think it would make you want to introduce our two beautiful guests.
I would love to have Cleveland and Miss Brooks out here with us.
Miss Robin Brooks.
Mm-hmm. Art Double R out here with us today. Glad to have y'all out here. We got trail ride coming up, girls.
We do.
Are y'all ready?
And we've got guests in the studio too.
You know who's excited about this trail ride? I was talking to Robert Reams of the
other day. Oh yeah,
he is excited. He's a real cowboy.
He is.
A big old
His
boy,
whole
too.
Family is.
Yeah.
He brought a horse out here one day.
Joe did. Yeah. Joe did. Thing made a big mess right back there.
The horse got excited.
But it's going to be at 315 Elkwood.
Yes.
Goodwater. I love this graphic. I was just telling Fred a while ago, I love this graphic, Robin.
Isn't that beautiful? Jim Denny created that for us.
Jim and his brother John, I still can't tell them apart, but this is a great, because this is going to hopefully be an annual event, y'all.
It will be.
And y'all can, what a great graphic to use for, that people will recognize.
Yes. I actually ordered t-shirts logo yesterday for all the volunteers.
Oh,
we
good.
Have 32 volunteers.
Fantastic.
And that the t-shirts will be black with that logo mm-hmm. on the front. That
yeah.
way we'll be easily identifiable mm-hmm. if someone needs help or has questions or something.
Tabitha, I want to ask you a question.
Sure.
When did you get into riding horses? Did you grow up in
yeah.
that?
Yeah. My dad and mom had horses when I was born.
Okay.
So I was not
Never
walking
know.
And in the saddle. So. And I rodeoed some when I was in high school. And
what'd you do? Barrel?
Barrels and
really?
Poles.
Did I not? I should have known that. I've known you and kept up with you, but
yeah, the Alabama Rodeo Association was, you know, a league.
You know, I think we're seeing that happen with more young folks.
Mm-hmm.
We've had a couple of them out here, young ladies,
and they amaze me with their work ethic. You know,
it teaches you so much.
Yeah. I mean, you know what it is. I mean, getting up every day.
Humility.
Yeah.
And it's hard work.
Yeah, yeah.
Very hard work.
And it's and it's every day. It's not just whenever you feel.
It's a lifestyle. Yeah,
you're right. How long did you do that?
Well, I rodeoed for a couple years when I was, you know, young teenager, 12, 13, 14 maybe.
When Robin and I were that age, we were showing calves together.
Yes.
4-H.
How was that? How was that, Robin?
She did all the work, and I just hung out.
I showed for 2 years, and it was not until the second year that I realized what was going to happen to my calf.
Oh, really?
And when they were having the auction to sell the calves, I walked around with my calf in the ring, crying my eyes out, so nobody really bid on it because they felt sorry for me.
I didn't know that.
I be darned.
And I never did it again.
Oh, you're auctioning them off?
Yes.
Uh-huh. I be darned.
Actually, I slept with him in the barn that last night.
I be darned. That's
because I was brokenhearted.
Yeah. I be darned.
But it was too late to back out.
I want to commend you on the excellent job you did last time you were on the show.
Thank you. It was tough.
Yeah,
but thank you. And
now,
thank you for allowing me to tell about my son.
Well, I think this is something I hope you will keep the show in mind for years to come to promote this, but to keep his namesake going. I mean, we don't ever want to forget Adam.
No, we don't.
I mean, you know.
In fact, when the ride is over with, I'd love for you to come back out and we'll talk about
the success. Exactly right.
And bring us some photos, too. We'll put them up.
Let's talk
Ryan
food.
Ryan won't let us fool with it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll have some food there. I don't go straight to the food right now. I know we got some other things, but what are we having to eat that day?
John Forbus is in charge of that, and it's a cast iron cooking. I don't know what all he is preparing, but he's got a big group coming in to help him.
Mm-hmm. They've done that before.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. You know, John may have the original no-name stew recipe from Jack Walker.
Jack Walker, Lord have mercy.
But John will do a great job.
Yes.
It'll be fabulous.
Will this be at the end of the ride that day? Or
no, it will be, we hope to have the meal ready by 11.
Okay.
The first flight of the ride will start at 9, and that will be the guided ride. I estimate, we've ridden the trail several times, I estimate it's going to be a 4 to 5 hour ride.
Wow.
And so when that first flight gets back, I'm sure they'll be ready to eat.
So it'll be
we'll have
to 2
food
o'clock
throughout the day, and the meal is included in the price for the riders, but anyone else who wants to just come and eat, we're just asking for a donation.
Let me ask you on that. You said a 4 or 5 hour ride. Is that a long time to ride, or is that just pretty much common when you go for a ride?
It's a long ride.
It'll
be a good, nice long ride.
Okay.
A normal, you know, a short ride, a couple hours. But it just depends. Some people are used to doing 8 hour, making a whole day of it.
Right.
So it's a good medium, you know, perfect for
if you're a regular rider.
Yes.
For you, it'd be a real long ride.
Have a sore rear end at the end of the day.
Among other things.
But let me ask you about this. For that, how many riders do you have signed up now? Or do you have a number?
It's going to be as they come in.
So
they'll, when they get there, they'll sign up and give their donation. And we also are allowing people to ride on their own. You don't have to do a guide, the guided ride. So, you know, and a lot of trail riders prefer that. They don't want to maybe be in a big group. And that's fine, too. You can go out on your own. It's very well marked.
You guys have been busy marking the trails, and so we don't have to come looking for somebody.
There has been a bushel of people that has worked
Fantastic.
Their tails off on this.
32 people. When you got that many, it seemed like that pretty well organized when you do it that.
Trying to be, yes.
Yeah. But this right here, again, it will be next Saturday, the 23rd, a one-day event. And then y'all will learn from this. You'll know next year what to do, what not to do. The time, I still think the time of the year is good for you. Just my opinion. Because mm-hmm. I know
we're praying for good weather.
Yeah. Well, there ain't nothing you can do about that. Well, I don't care when you put it down.
I try to tell myself, but I can pray, so I'm doing
exactly
that.
Exactly right. Do you pray more now than you did before the loss?
I do. I do.
What do you pray about? Because prayer is a very personal thing with me. I mean, I'm kind of crazy with my relationships with anybody, but the man upstairs, I've got my own. Me and him talk just like I'm talking to y'all right now. He don't understand everything I say, but I stutter around so. But
well, my prayer has changed mm-hmm. from when this first happened. Mm-hmm. You know, I used to pray for Adam's safety every
right.
time I knew
yeah.
he was working
right.
on the helicopter. And then after this happened, I prayed for strength. And I pray for God to help me to trust him
mm-hmm.
and
mm-hmm.
Pray for comfort
mm-hmm.
and for peace. And now, you know, I still pray for those things, but sometimes I just say, tell my Adam I love him.
Yeah, yeah. Golly. You know, I think about, I've thought about you a lot, especially when you were on last, and are you able, or do you plan on going to, you've been very kind to share this on the show with us, but have you, do you go to, when people ask you to go talk about that, churches or civic groups, or is that something you don't want to?
Well, I have private? Not been asked, but I would.
Yeah.
Last time I was on here, mm-hmm. Randy Clark and Paul Stepp from Things Going On in Sylacauga mm-hmm. came to my home and mm-hmm. interviewed myself and mm-hmm. my daughter Rachel.
Mm-hmm. But I think about, and we talked about this last time, Robin, I think it has to be talked about. I think other people, others have gone through this. Have you had the opportunity to talk with another mom or dad or that's gone through that same tragedy?
I have. And
are you able to share? I mean, you know, this is...
Well, mine is very unique.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
I wish I knew another mother who has had the same experience,
mm-hmm.
But I don't. And I hope there's never another one.
Right. I talked to Representative Ed Oliver, who used to do the same thing. And he says that, you know, so many of those guys and gals that, you know, he never knew when they were coming back. I mean, it's a risk. It's a risk.
It is a
but
risk.
That's what he wanted. He loved what he did, didn't he?
He did. And I'll be honest, he was getting burned out.
Uh-huh. Wow.
And was... honestly, seriously considering changing jobs.
What was he wanting to do?
Be a firefighter.
Really?
That was his first love.
It was his first love, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
yeah.
Yes, and he never gave up loving that.
Yeah, yeah.
He continued. He started out at the LX City Fire Department
okay.
full-time, became
okay.
a professional firefighter,
mm-hmm.
Went back to college and got his nursing degree,
mm-hmm.
and he tried working in a hospital, but that was not for him.
Mm-hmm.
And then he had the opportunity to go to work for Air Methods
mm-hmm.
Lifesaver 4, at the Lifesaver 4 base.
Right.
And he worked there about 14 years.
I didn't know.
And he was just...
Wow.
I mean, it wears on you.
Yeah,
especially,
I can't imagine.
Especially if it's a child.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He didn't talk to me very often about it, but mm-hmm. if it was a child, it really... bothered him, and he had a hard time dealing with that and getting over it.
He was a people person, wasn't he?
Very much so.
And he had a passion for helping.
Speaking of children, I was going to ask you a while ago, and we got talking about something else. Is there an age limit or an age?
No limits.
So
okay.
If there's a child, just be there with a parent.
That's right, yes.
Okay.
We'll talk more about this when we come back. Don't go anywhere. You think you can handle this?
I know I can handle it. Anytime we talk about a Mitchell, you can bet your bottom dollar I can handle it. Let's talk about the Mitchell House. Where is the Mitchell House? Come on, don't tell me that. It's been there since 1835. Located in downtown Dadeville, Alabama. It's rich, rich in history. Look, your next event's coming up. Give them a call right now, 256-307-1225, and say, I want the Kenny Dean special for the Mitchell House, downtown Dadeville.
Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center provides optimum care for the whole person. Dr. Dimo Popov specializes in the prevention and diagnosis of high blood pressure, kidney disease, diabetes, and acute and chronic conditions. Our weight loss clinic offers lipo shots and a guide to healthy weight loss. Alex City Internal Medicine and Nephrology and Weight Loss Center, where lifestyle changes are made.
Benton Clearing and Grading is Cody and A.O.D. Benton, and they get your job in sight. Moving dirt is a clean job to them. Clearing a lot for your home or business is what they do, and they do it right. Call A.O.D. or Cody today at 256-397-2531 or 397-2532 for a quote today. I promise you, they'll do the job right. That's Benton Clearing and Grading.
Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation is coming soon to the corner of 280 and 49 North in Dadeville. This new 10,000 square foot facility is conveniently located to serve the residents of the Lake Martin area and its many communities. A branch of Frederick Dean Funeral Home and Crematory in Opelika, Lake Martin Funeral Home and Cremation looks forward to serving your families and your communities, as we have since 1900 at Frederick Dean. 256-750-0381.
With numerous industrial sites across the area, first-class workforce development initiatives, and a business-friendly climate, Tallapoosa and Coosa counties have just what your company needs to be successful. To find out more, visit lakemartineda.com or call 256-215-4404 to speak to Executive Director Denise Walls. Let us make it work for you. Call 256-215-4404.
I'm used to living alone, taking care of myself, Mr. Independent. But every now and then, I need a little help. My kids aren't close, and I want to stay in my own home. As close as family is such a godsend. Caring professionals here to help me with all the little things. Taking care of the house and myself, keeping me looking sharp. Feeling sharp, too.
Learn more at asclosesfamily.com.
They really are as close as family.
Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply Stores have the tools and materials to get the job done right, whether you're a professional contractor or just a weekend do-it-yourselfer. With everyday customer conveniences like a drive-through lumber yard, price match promise, and our best rewards program, each of our 9 locations offer top brands and building materials like lumber, hardware, tools, paint, lawn and garden, and much more. Visit today and see what Russell DeWitt Center and Building Supply can help you build tomorrow.
The food at Oscar's Cafe makes your mouth water. At Oscar's, enjoy great-tasting catfish, or maybe you're just in the mood for one of Oscar's fresh salads. Even kids know the place for a fine meal is Oscar's, with a great kids menu. Oscar's also has great-tasting burgers full of backyard flavor. So come on out to Oscar's Cafe for great food and homegrown hospitality. We're located on Highway 49 South in Dadeville, just before the Blue Creek Bridge. And remember, it's all fun and games till there's only one cheese ball left.
We've been giving Terry something he'd been needing a long time, a negative Coggin test, and no alcohol.
I'm going to be doing the alcohol while I give him that negative cognitive test. Well, that is for the horses.
So if I, if I score negative, I passed it. Is that right?
That's right.
That's right. I've never heard, really, seriously, I've never heard of that. So do they have to give proof on paper, or do you just?
It's preferred.
No, they just ask a horse, kid.
But you can also have a phone copy.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's just.
Most horse people
in a horse's annual vet appointment,
a little
this
more
is
than
a
you
normal
did.
Test. Okay. So they should have them.
They understand
it
all.
Took a lot of folks to make this happen.
It did.
Who were some of them? I know we might forget some of them, but
well, I
let's
made
tell
a
some
list,
of them, thanks.
So hopefully I won't forget.
Okay.
First and foremost, Tommy and Beverly Bass and David Thrash.
Mm-hmm.
They have offered the use of their farms for the trail rides. Tommy and Beverly have a 1,200-acre farm that Hatchet Creek runs through.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Absolutely beautiful. And David's property borders theirs.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going on David's some because he has a couple of places that are so scenic. One is a waterfall.
Mm-hmm.
And then where his cabin is probably one of the prettiest places on Hatchet Creek.
Mm-hmm.
There's a big bend in the creek. It's wide. There's white water. Is gorgeous.
Unbelievable.
So, and we've got several trails that are right along the creek.
Mm-hmm.
It's just
it'll be
gorgeous.
A beautiful ride.
Yes.
Trail riders will love it.
Yeah.
And in addition, we've had so many people that have come forward, donated things to be raffled or for door prizes.
Mm-hmm.
Matthew Reams, who owns Triple R Restaurant, is donating a lot of the ingredients for the meal. And Lori Manning, who owns Lori Darling's restaurant in Fayetteville, is donating some food and desserts for the meal. Trailwares, Nancy Willis in Sylacauga has donated a gift basket that will be raffled. Hanover Homemade is donating three of her cakes that we will raffle. Julie Blankenship is donating desserts. Beautiful Salon here in Elk City has donated two $100 gift certificates that we will raffle. Cloud Nine is giving a door prize. Downtown Girl is giving a gift certificate.
Mm-hmm.
Brandy McDaniel is giving two paintings. The Lily, which is a florist in Sylacauga, is donating a gift basket of live flowers. Triple R is donating a dinner for two, and these are things that will be given as door prizes. El Vaquero's in Rockford is going to give a dinner for door prize. The Mercantile on Broad in Sylacauga will give a gift certificate. Sure Shot, Tractor Supply. For Sale Farms has given they have given us a package. It's a golf package for four at Farm Links, which is, I'm sure, the prettiest golf course in the state, if not
You're
the
right.
Southeast.
Mm-hmm.
It's a $1,000 value. We will be selling raffle tickets. We're not having the drawing until May 1st.
Oh, okay.
But it is a golf package for four. And it includes 18 rounds of golf. It includes golf carts, use of practice facilities.
And that, what kind of value?
It's $1,000 value.
It's every bit of $1,000.
Yeah.
Yes. So those are our biggest donors. Jim Denny is donating his time and talent. He will be our professional photographer. And, of course, Suzanne Schultz.
You like her. You've seen her.
Yeah. She will be performing for us from 11 to 1.
You know, one thing, listen, all those sponsors, which I know we all appreciate deeply, but it reminds me of the million-dollar fishing tournament that started years back and the way those sponsors have grown because they believe in it. Folks, this is something, that, since it is going to be an annual event, you'll see that list grow bigger and bigger and bigger, and the scholarship gets bigger and bigger and bigger.
But now, ladies, this is a trail ride, but it's not just for trail riders.
That's right.
You've got room for folks like Kenny who rides that stick right. pony.
Well, there'll be some entertainment with Suzanne.
That's right.
And Jim is selling portraits mm-hmm. that he's taken mm-hmm. for a donut. You know, the money goes towards the foundation. So.
How about if you want to come over and have lunch, you can do that?
Yes.
Oh, of course. Okay. Yes, that's a main good point.
I mean, if you've never had food cooked by the commissioner, you need to go over there.
Hiking, is that something that, I mean, you know, there's a lot of hikers around here. Is
right?
that something?
Yeah. We would just suggest go out after the horses are off the trail just to keep from accidents happening.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Any surprises out there
yeah,
for
with,
them?
I'm with you.
But
watch
yes.
out what those horses. They ain't gonna.
I knew you'd do
well,
it.
Man,
that's just good advice.
Isn't it? Yeah. We've had them here. We know what they can do even on the front porch. It's part
what time
of
would lunch start if they wanted to come?
Well, he wants to have the food done ready by 11.
Okay.
That way, if people are coming through that aren't mm-hmm. riding, they can, you know, socialize and listen to Suzanne.
Buy
and
a rifle
meal,
ticket.
Buy yes. tickets, have their pictures made. It's a beautiful place out there to have
beautiful.
A picture. Mm-hmm.
Bring the family, have your
yeah.
picture made.
Yeah.
Yes.
It'll make a great
postcard,
Christmas card.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
We'll have horses out, and like if people are there and they're not riding and they have kids that want to ride, we have horses there.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
they'll get an opportunity to
But they will
to
be
ride.
Led on those horses.
Okay. But here again, that's a memory maker for those little
ones. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Pictures made.
And then they can have their pictures on the horse.
Yeah.
You know,
well, I'm so glad that this is happening. And again, we do want y'all to come back out here. Maybe the week after, I'll send y'all some dates to look at, because just to see maybe some pictures and that type of things. I know it's going to be a lot of pictures, you know,
yes,
taken for this,
yes.
too.
We would love to.
We'll kind of run down this right here before we take our break. 25 minimum donation. All proceeds go to the Adam Russell Scholarship Foundation. That's the bottom line we want
to. And it's
to
a 501c3, so they're
yes.
tax deductible too, by the way.
Cash or check preferred, Venmo accepted. Price includes cast iron cooking meal, Hanover homemade cake raffle, and then you just heard a long list of a whole lot more. You can go to give your telephone number.
Yes, absolutely.
256-334-1221 or email brooksrobin58@cloud.com.
At iCloud.com.
And we'll continue to remind y'all about this every day. We'll be right back and we'll wrap it up. What's Current Market is where it's going on for lunch day. Let me tell you about What's Current Market lunch. When was the last time you had a chicken salad sandwich? I'm talking about a fresh chicken salad sandwich or a BLT, and maybe some chicken and dumplings to go with it. That's just one. They got several different soups. But try that out today at What's Current Market. They serve lunch from 10:30 until 2.
It's truck season at Glenn Smith Chevrolet in Opelika. Check out the powerful full-size and fully loaded Chevrolet Silverado LTZ, discounted up to $11,000 off, or the roomy midsize three-row SUV, the Chevy Traverse, discounted up to $7,750 off, and the perfect size Chevy Equinox up to $7,750 off. No payments until summertime. Over 350 new and used vehicles on the lot or on the way.
Get ready to smile.
Hi, I'm Pastor Ben Hayes from First Baptist Church, Dadeville, Alabama, and I have an exciting opportunity I want to share with you. On March 31st, Easter Sunday, we're going to have a great day of worship just for you. 8:15, we'll have our first morning worship service, followed at 9:30 by breakfast for everyone. 9:45, we'll have Sunday school Bible study time for all age groups. 11 o'clock will be our second worship service. So get this, 8:15 worship service, 9:30 breakfast, 9:45 Sunday school, 11 o'clock worship, and we want to see you there.
Carlisle Heat and Air says it's tune-up time for your HVAC system. Having your unit tuned up increases energy efficiency and can reduce the wear and tear on your unit. Call Carlisle Heat and Air Day at 256-234-0019 for a price. Serving the Lake Martin area, Alexander City, Dadeville, Jackson Gap, and Goodwater. Don't get hot,
be cool.
Call Carlisle Heating and Air today at 256-234-0019. Don't get hot. Be cool.
For those who missed Zaxby's Egg Rolls the first time, these hand-rolled bundles of deliciousness are back. Just in time to take a sweet and spicy dip. Yes, you heard that right. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's. Egg rolls are back at Zaxby's. They're hand-rolled and come with a delicious sweet and spicy dipping sauce. But enough from me. Let the egg rolls do the talking. And there you have it. Two for $3 egg rolls. Woo, saucy! Zaxby's.
Wintertime in the South is mild compared to other parts of the country, but we still tend to be less active and spend more time indoors. Show your heart some love this winter by getting it checked out at the UAB Heart and Vascular Clinic at Russell Medical. I'm Dr. Kevin Sublett, and our entire clinic is dedicated to keeping your heart healthy. We're right here in your own community and backed by the knowledge and expertise of UAB Medicine. Make an appointment today by calling 256-234-2644 or visit uabmedicine.org/heartrussell.
While in Daveville, Alabama, get off the roundabout and stop in Payne's Furniture. Donald Payne says right now the selection of couches with end tables is unbelievable. Comfortable bedding, rustic bedding, area rug selection like he's never had. Beautiful dining tables, modern and rustic. Ask him about financing. Or if you want to call him at 256-825-7727. That's Payne's Furniture in downtown Daveville.
Tapley Appliance is now Presley Appliance and Furniture. It's all the same friendly staff. And Mike and Trevor Presley not only offer the best in appliances from Whirlpool, KitchenAid, and Maytag, but now we offer full lines of furniture from Ashley, as well as a great selection of outdoor furniture. Make sure to visit the Presley family at the all-new Presley Appliance and Furniture on Cherokee Road in Alex City. Same great service and appliances, now with a great selection of furniture for home and outdoor.
Just got this from the Elks. The drawdown is tomorrow night. Doors at 4:30, cash bar to 5:30, then open bar 6:30, dinner, then drawing at 7:30, and then next weekend, it's showtime.
It is.
Showtime. Gates open at 7 o'clock. Guided ride starts at 9 o'clock. Non-guided riders begin
at their leisure.
Okay, okay. It will be at the Bass Farm in Hanover. We'll continue to remind you of it, and we'll continue to remind you how to get in touch with these girls to make your donation, but get signed up for it. A lot of, and it wouldn't surprise me if your gifts and donations, or not donation, but gifts, continue to come in. People say, I want to be a part of it.
It's been amazing. Okay. It's really.
I'm going to give you her number one more time. Robin Brooks, 256-334-1221. Brooks Robin 58 at iCloud.com.
There you
Y'all
go.
Have a great weekend.
Have a great weekend.